Welcome, co-integration in practice using Stata and R. That is our video for today. We shall first of all discuss Angel-Granger co-integration procedure using Stata, then in the next video Johansson co-integration procedure, and then ARDL co-integration procedure. Data sets are given in the links with each video and their source. First of all, we are going to do Angel-Granger co-integration using Stata. So what is Angel-Granger co-integration procedure using Stata? We have data here, which is basically in term format USA, Australia, GDP, and we are basically first of all going to deal with the issues of setting data as time. So if you look here, time, this is string variable here. This is string in nature. So we need to encode, and it is quarterly data from 1970 quarter one. So here time generate quarterly, not possible with numeric variable. So we have this string variable, which is time, capital T. Okay, no, we need to generate data, generate date variable equal to quarter minus one. As Stata starts from 1960 quarter two, we have to start from quarter one TQ to 1970 Q1. Okay, and now we date format is year and quarter. Okay, now you can go to statistics and you can use tset command, and you can set your data as time series. Here you have date variable, and date variable, set it quarterly, submit. Okay, everything goes fine. So we are with 1970 to 2000 quarter four data. You can do okay. Again, it will be generated, it's okay. Now, first of all, we need to have a two-way line plot, two-way line USA, AUS, and date variable. So this is how you see that both variables are non-stationary. How to take lag selection and all that, that I will explain in Johansson co-integration procedure. So, what is Angel-Granger? In Angel-Granger, first of all, we regress a variable on another variable, and then we take the residuals and we use the lag of those residuals in the next equation, and there the lag of the residuals is ECM, or that is your long run relationship. So we regress AUS on USA with no constant. So we get this one. Now we predict residuals, predict double residual, residuals. We have named a variable residge. Okay. Now we regress D dot AUS. We are basically the data were non-stationary at level. We are taking difference on lag of residge and one leg of each of the variables in difference form, because they were stationary at level, non-stationary at level. So you see, in this case, this long run coefficient, this error correction term minus 0.0088, and this is minus 1. At 10% level, we say that US economy affects Australian economy. And similarly, we do the same equation, but our dependent variable is now a difference of USA, and we see what happens. So in this case, what do we conclude? That this is not significant. So if it is significant, then its sign should have been a cause of concern for us. So we say that this is not significant. So, preliminary results indicate that Australian economy is not affecting US economy. But it's all too premature. So there are so many other variables. When you have more than two variables, then we have to go for Johansson co-integration procedure. This data are from Principle of Econometrics using R. Chapter 12, I guess. I'll provide this a link for this data, and you can play with this. Thank you for watching. Take care.